Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We're here 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. You are what you believe you are. Humans are powerful magicians. You have the power to make yourself what you are right now, but it's not your reasoning mind that controls your power. It's what you believe. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 471, NASDAQ up 59, S&P's up 34. That's a gain of 1.6% in the Dow Industrials, 0.6% in the NASDAQ, and 1% in the S&P. You have the NDX 100 as well as the NASDAQ Composite, folks. That hit all-time highs this morning, at all-time highs yesterday. They broke topside yesterday. Today, it's lagging, but the bottom line, the laggard was the Dow Industrials, and that thing is picking up steam. That's up 472 right now. If we go inside the Dow Industrials and we take a look at the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow Industrials out here, you're going to see United Health is the big mover inside there. Well, you got a lot of them. United Health is putting 102 positive points, Boeing 70, IBM 53, 3M 30, Travelers 27. Taken away from it, Disney minus 19, Merck minus 19, Visa minus 6, and Nike minus 4. No big deal there, no doubt. So bottom line is that what you do see is that you see the Dow Industrials catching up with the other indices. It looks like the Dow does want to, when you get this close to a high, it wants to whack that high. Gold. Gold contract up $6.40, trading at $15.56 an ounce. We get over and we take a look at that gold market. What we have inside the gold market right now, gold went down to a low today of $15.51. You rejected lower price at that level. Bottom line, we tested the lows of yesterday. You're going to come in, first off, with yesterday, you came into the strength. You did that with lighter volume. Today, you got to a lower low with lighter volume without making the swing low, which is pretty cool, folks. 1542 is the swing point. When you don't make the swing point, you do the test, you reject it. Bottom line, I suspect gold's now going to go once again for the top of this range. The top of this range now is 1595 to 1598. That is the B point of this complex ABC structure on the way up. And we're still in a complex ABC structure. That's the bottom line. Silver market. Silver is a different animal out here. It has been a different animal for a long period of time. And what we had with the silver market was this. Silver yesterday, you know, gold was getting smacked on the way down. Silver, bottom line, you know, only went down a penny. Today, you got to a lower low. You did reject it. You had lighter volume. That's saying that silver also is going to make its way to higher price. Now, notes and bonds. This is the market. This is going to be pretty intense watching this market shake out. The reason being is that what we had out here is that you're down 10 ticks. We are trading at a price point of 130.18. You're down with 234,000 contracts. So that's good contract volume. I mean, that's, you know, it's lighter than what we're going into. But that being said, it's just slightly light. I mean, you are banging into about 2.6, 2.3. I suspect it's going to be doing about 2.4. And when that gets set up like that, more than likely, maybe tomorrow we test the lows of this once again. When you go, that's the 10-year. We go take a look at the 30-year. I expect it's going to be the same. They trade in the same aspects. 371,000 contracts in the 30-year. That's decent contract volume, no doubt, on the way down. And what are we doing? You're going right into the same type of strength. This is interesting. So there is a differential in here, and this is what it is. It's pretty substantial, actually. The 30-year is actually going into 487,000 contracts, and you have rejected lower price at this particular point. So there's less sellers there in the 30-year. That's a good heads up. There's also less sellers in the TLT, which is the 20-year plus ETF. That baby is doing 7 million going into about 10. The oil. Let's go take a look at the oil market. Oil caught a bid out here this morning. When you say caught a bid, bottom line is that it's about time that it caught a bid, because guess what? Oil has been a one-way trade. And when I say one-way trade, this is pretty amazing. We go back to the January 8th, and it was at $65.40. Yesterday, last night, it hit $49.31. You get a pop out here. You know, hey, listen, it's a start. That's the real bottom line. You got to start, you know, we'll see if this baby can, a normal, let me see what a dead cat bounce is. So a dead cat bounce, folks, would be a 0.38 to retracement of the way down. So a point, check this out, a 0.38 to retracement is 55.50. So that could get a bounce up there. You know, we'll see whether it can even get that high. I don't expect we're going to get that high, but we'll see. If we go to large integrated oils, ExxonMobil caught a bid out here today. That's been a one-way route on the way down. We just went from 72 down to 60. It's at up 263 today, trading 62.60. We take a look at Chevron. What do you have with Chevron? Same type of setup. Chevron has just gone from $122 down to $105. That is up $3.17 today. And this volume on Chevron, though, is absolutely anemic in a huge way. Got to go through Tesla. Tesla, this is no doubt, this is a wild equity. And what you have with Tesla out here, Tesla is down $146, trading $7.40, and we are off the highs of yesterday of $224. And what we are going to be having, folks, in the next few days is that you're going to be getting the 13F filings. Now, the 13F filings have to be out within 45 days. We get a few early ones out here that have filed. And if you happen to be watching Tiger TV, what you're going to see is this one filing that a company sold all their shares except 39,000. They sold 8.2 million shares in the filing. And what that actually is the public investment fund of Saudi Arabia. So Saudi Arabia sold all their Tesla shares, excluding 39,000 as of December 31st. And if you go back, I'm sure they did great, because you go back to December 31st, Tesla was trading anywhere from, well, let's see, if I do the whole quarter. So September, October, November, December, January. So it's November, December, January. So you get between 314 and 424. Now, yes, granted, you're at 740, but guess what? You could be at 314 tomorrow. Pretty amazing. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow Industrials up 452. NASDAQ up 48. S&P's up 32. We'll come right back.